Okay. What other videos that obviously made no sense to stay on, they would leave it on? What other videos did you see where you're like, okay, there's, like, for example, the pig video you talked about, did that one get taken down?
So that one did get taken down, but it got taken down specifically because that was not one that was in the general area of where we get our content from. That one was in a private Facebook page. And this was what I really specialized in, was that there were a lot of private pages and they would be named something like I Love Dogs or Let's Go Bulldogs or anything like that. And so you would just see it. It would be like a very general name. You wouldn't think anything bad about it. And it was a private only page. So you could only go to that page if you were invited. So if you were actually invited to that page,
I got you.
Then realize that it was actually just a cesspool of specialized content that was horrific and disgusting. And what made it the worst is that these videos and these private pages, they were homemade. They were not from other websites. There were people that were making these videos, and they were inviting people into the page to buy and auction the videos. So what the hardest part about that was, is that they were using the Facebook payment system. They were using other means of getting currency, and they would have a horrific video, such as the video of the pig and the girl. And people would actually bet an auction on how much money so they could get the full video. And then that person that made the original video would also take requests from others and make content specialized to tailored to them. So that's what I dealt with. And a lot of this type of content that was homemade by the parents, by the children, by the people that were making money off of it, this was stuff that was just in the private area of these private pages. And Facebook would not allow me to do anything about it, because even if I wrote the report, even if I could prove that they were in America, even if I had their driver's license, their face, their license plate, their home address, they said that it would look bad for them. And they said that an internal Facebook team would look at it. And yet that same content was still on there.
So are you saying if they really wanted to catch the bad guy, they could, but because they could figure out where it's coming from? Is that kind of what you're saying?
Yes. And I figured out where a lot of the content was coming from. So did my coworkers that worked with me on the desk.
So it wasn't hard for you to figure that out?
It was not, because people put their names on their content. They will actually like make it a brand. They will be stupid enough to show their house, their home address. They are stupid enough to have their car license plate show up in the video. They are dumb enough to say their first and last name.
Even though this is a homemade video, you can easily send this to the FBI, but Facebook didn't want to do that. Why? Is it because they don't want the users to feel uncomfortable that the information is being shared with a third party? Is that kind of what their alibi was?
No. In fact, their alibi was that they were saying that this content going public would be bad for Facebook's optics. So they would just have an internal investigation through Facebook's own team. And obviously that went nowhere when you would see the same profiles, the same pictures, making the same content back the next day. Nothing ever happened to them, and they're making new content to go with it.